'Tis done. But yesterday a king, and armed with king to strive, and now thou art a nameless thing, so abject, yet alive. Is this a man of thousand thrones, who's to our earth with hostile bones, and can he thus survive? Since he miscalled the morning star, no man, no fiend had fallen so far. Ill-minded man, why skirts thy country bow so low the knee? By gazing on thyself, grown blind, thou tosterest to see. With my unquestioned power to save, thine only gift has been the grave to those that worship thee. Not till thy fall could mortal guess ambitions less than littleness. Thanks for that lesson. It will teach to after warriors more than high philosophy can preach and vainly preach before. That spell upon the minds of men breaks never to unite again, that led them to adore the spaded things of sabre sway with front of brass and feet of clay. The triumph and the vanity, the rupture of the strife, the earthquake voice of victory. To thee the fact of life, the sword, the scepter, and that sway with mancy paper to obey, where good renown would thrive. All quell, dark spirit, what must be the madness of thy memory? The desolator? Desolate. The victor of the throne, the arbiter of others' fates. A suppliant for his own. We disarmed imperial hope that with such change can calmly cope. Or dread of death alone, to die a prince, or live a slave. Thy choice is most ignobly brave. Of thy strength, an equal deed has done at length, and darker fate has found. He fell, the forest prowler's prey, but thou must eat thy heart away. Would with his burning heart was slick with blood of Rome, threw down the dagger, dare depart in savage grandeur. Rome, he did depart in utter scorn of men the such a yoke had borne, yet left it such a doom. With only glory was that hour of self-appelled abandoned power. The Spaniard, when the lust of sway hath lost its quickening spell, cast crowns for rosaries away, an empire for a cell. A strict accountant of his beads, a subtle disputant on crease, he stored his trifled well, yet better had he neither known a bigger shrine nor desperate throne. Reluctant hand, the thunderbolt is rung. Too late, thou leave the high command to which thy weakness clung. All evil spirit as thou art, it is enough to grieve the heart to see thine own unstrung, to think that God's fair word has been the footstool of a thing so mean. Spilt a blood for him who thus can hard his own, and monarchs bowed a trembling limb and thanked him for a throne. Fair freedom, we may hold thee dear, when thus the mightiest foes their fear in humblest skies have shown. On any tyrant leave behind a brighter name to loom mankind. Thy evil deeds are written gore, not written thus in vain. Thy triumph tell of fame no more, or deepen every stain. If thou hadst died as honor dies, some unicorn might arise to shame the world again. But who would sow the solar hide to set in such a starless night? Weight in the balance, here a dust is vile as vulgar clay. Thy scales, mortality, are just to all that pass away. But yet, methought the living great some higher sparks should animate to dazzle and dismay. Not in contempt could thus make mirth of this, the conquerors of the earth. And she, proud Austria's mournful flower, thy steel imperial bride, her best abreast, a taunting hour, still clings she to thy side. Must she to bend, must she to shed a late repentance, long despair? Thou crownless homicide. If still she loves thee, hold a gem to wear that vanished diadem. Then hie thee to thy sullen isle and gaze upon the sea. That lament may meet thy smile. It ne'er was ruled by thee. All graced with an idle hand in loitering mood upon the sand. Never is now as free that Corinth's pedagogue had not transferred his power to thy brow. Thou, tamer, in his captive cage, what force will there be thine while brooding in that prison rent? But one, the word was mine. Unless the key of Babylon, all senses with that scepter gone, life would not long confine that spirit, pass so widely forth, so long obeyed, so little worth. Wilt thou withstand the shock and share with them the unforgiven, his vulture and his wrath? Forgotten by God, by man, a curse that at last took, though now thy worst of everything's arch mock. He in his fall preserved his pride, and if a mortal, proudly died. There was a day, there was an hour, while air was gold, gold thine, with an immeasurable power, unsated to resign, had been an act of pure fame, that countless of my ringless name, and ill did thy decline. That long twilight of old time, despite some passing clouds of crime. But thou, forsooth, must be a king and donned a purple vest, as if a foolish rod could ring remembrance for thy breast. Where is thy faded garment? Where the gewgaws thou wert fond to wear? The star, the string, the crest, vain forward shove of empire, say, are all thy playthings snatched away? Neither guilty glory glows, nor despicable stain. Yes, one, the first, the last, the best, the Cincinnatus.